Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to a prophetic message to start this day. My child, do not be concerned with the things that you cannot control, but surrender them instead to me today. For my grace is sufficient for you to overcome even the regrets of the past, the present struggles that you are facing, and even the uncertainty of your future. Yes, I am coming soon, and I will collect my bride that has made herself ready. So put your faith and trust in me fully today to see you through, my child. The cares of this world will melt away when you spend time with me. Yes, for it is time for you to surrender those weaknesses. For in that surrender can I be made stronger. See, I know you better than anyone else, even better than yourself. So surrender every fear and allow my presence to fill your heart with peace today like a river. For my river will never run dry. So I beckon you to come today and drink of this water, that you may be satisfied and also renewed, my child, within the light of my glory. For I am with you, my child, and will not forsake those that are not ashamed of me. Come and drink this day, and though you have nothing to offer, just come with a humble heart, and I will give you rest and revive your soul once again. Be at peace and know that I am your God who loves you with an everlasting love. Shalom. Praise the Lord, precious saints. The Bible says, according to 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. See, God is so gracious to provide strength when it is needed, precious saints, so that we can find our identity, our confidence, and our contentment always in Him. No matter what you are passing through this day, His grace is always sufficient for us. According to Philippians 4, verses 11 to 13, Paul also illustrates the same idea. And he says these words, not that I speak in regards to need, for I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. I know how it is to be abased, and I know how it is to abound. Everywhere and in all things, I have learned both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And God wants to strengthen you also today, precious saints. See, Paul explains that he has learned how to be content in any circumstance, no matter how severe it may be, no matter how severe it may look today, in the uncertainty of everything that is happening around us today, precious saints, there is one thing we can trust, and that is God is God. That is right. See, when things are going well or when things are going badly, even Paul knew that contentment doesn't come from circumstances. Contentment comes rather from recognizing that we can do whatever God intends for us to do through Christ who strengthens us. God is so gracious to provide us that strength when it is needed, precious saints. Remember, our identity is found in Him, our confidence is found in Him, and our contentment is found in Him also. See, this is what God meant when He said that His grace is sufficient. It is all we need, precious saints, and it will carry each of us through until He comes to collect His bride. Hallelujah. Let us pray now, precious saints. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, we know that you are merciful. And we have been told that you provide grace and mercy in spite of our behavior, in spite of our weaknesses and our mistakes. And you are a good God that comes to those that need you, no matter what. Yes, Lord. And today, Lord, we need you now in our lives more than ever before. We know that we are not perfect, and we know that our sins are not hidden from you. So today, Lord, forgive us today for every word, for every thought, for every deed that has been done that is not of you. Wash us, Lord, with the precious blood of your Son Jesus Christ today. Yes, we thank you that we have been set free from the law of sin and death, but the Spirit of life, who indwells within our hearts and who teaches us your truth and knowledge. For you are faithful and gracious God, who is rich in mercy and love. And we thank you that we have been redeemed by Christ, and we are fully justified in your eye because he has made sin on our account, and he was made sin on our account and paid the full price of our sins. How we praise you that by God's grace, we have been brought back into fellowship with you, Father. And we thank you, Father, that your Son, the Christ, is raised from the dead and has become the first fruit of those that rise, and that we are partakers of his eternal life. And we thank you that there is no condemnation today for those who are in Christ Jesus. Father, we bow in worship and praise before you this day. We cover ourselves with the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, as our protection. We surrender ourselves completely and unreservedly in every area of our life to you today. And we take a stand against all the workings of Satan that would hinder within our prayer life. And we command Satan, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to leave our presence with all of his demons. And we bring the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ between Satan and ourselves today in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we worship you and give you praise. And we recognize that you are worthy to receive all glory and honor and praise. And we renew our allegiance to you fully and pray that the blessed Holy Spirit would enable us in this time of prayer. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, that you have loved us from past eternity and that you sent your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, into the world to die as our substitute. And we thank you that the Lord Jesus Christ came as our representative, and that through him that you have completely forgiven us. You have adopted us into your family. You have assured all responsibility for us. Yes, you have given us eternal life. You have given us the perfect righteousness of your Son, Jesus Christ, so that we are now justified. And we thank you that in him, your Son, you have made our complete. You've made us complete, and you have offered yourself to us, to even daily in our helps and our strength. And we thank you for the grace that is available to each person today. We are thankful for the armor that you have provided us also. Yes, we put and gird ourselves with truth today. We also put on the breastplate of righteousness, the sandals of peace, and the helmet of salvation. And we lift up the shield of faith against all the fiery darts of the enemy. And we take in our hand the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. We choose to use your Word against all the forces of evil within our lives. And we put on this armor and live and pray in complete dependence upon you each and every day. We thank you that we are grateful, Heavenly Father, that the Lord Jesus Christ spoiled all principalities and powers and made a show of them openly and triumph over them in himself. And we claim all that victory for our lives today also. And we reject all the insinuations and the accusations and the temptations of Satan today. We affirm that the Word of God is true. And we choose to live today in the light of your Word. Yes, we choose, Heavenly Father, to live in obedience to you and in fellowship with yourself. Open our eyes today and show us the areas of our life that have not pleased you, the areas that you want us to improve or change. Work in us to cleanse us from all ground that would give Satan a foothold against us. We do stand today as your adopted child. Yes, and we welcome all the ministry of the Holy Spirit within our lives, and by faith and in dependence upon you fully, we put off the old man and stand into all the victory of the crucifixion of your Son, Jesus Christ, who provided us from to be cleansed from the old nature. And we put on the new man and we stand into all the victory of the resurrection and the provision that he made for us to live above all sin. Therefore, today we put off the old nature with its selfishness, and we put on the new nature with its perfect love, and we put off the old nature with its fear, and we put on the new nature with its courage. We put off the old nature with its weakness, and we put on the new nature with its strength. We put off the old nature with all of its deceitful lusts, and we put on the new nature with its righteousness, with its purity and honesty. In every way, we stand into the victory of the ascension and the glorification of our Lord Jesus Christ, whereby all principalities and powers were made subject to him on the cross. And we claim our place in Christ as victorious with him over all the enemies of our soul. And we thank you, Holy Spirit, and we pray that you would fill us, that you would come into our lives, that you would break down every idol and cast out every foe today that is coming against us. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for the expression of your Son who came to defeat the devil today in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, we completely surrender ourselves to you, Heavenly Father, as a living sacrifice today. We choose not to be conformed to this world, but we choose to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. And we pray that you would show us your will and enable us to walk in all the fullness of your will today. And we are thankful, Heavenly Father, that the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to pulling down strongholds, to casting down of imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and to bring every thought into the obedience of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, in our own life today, we tear down the strongholds of Satan, and we smash the plans of Satan that has been formed against us. We tear down the strongholds of Satan against our mind, and we surrender our mind to you. Blessed Holy Spirit, we ask that you would affirm us today more now than ever before. And Father, we thank you that you have not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. And we break and smash the strongholds of Satan formed against our emotions today. And we give our emotions over to you. Yes, we yield to you today fully. And we smash the strongholds of Satan formed against our will today. And we give our will to you. And we choose to make the right decisions of faith. We smash the strongholds of Satan formed against our bodies today, and we give our bodies to you, recognizing that we are a temple And you are inside of us, and we recognize in your mercy and goodness, Jesus, that you will come and deliver us today. Heavenly Father, we pray that now and through this day that you would strengthen and enlighten us, show us the way to be able to overcome every area of the enemy that has been against us, enabled us to be the kind of person that you would be pleasing to you. Enable us, Lord, to overcome in every area of our life today because we know that your grace is sufficient. Give us that grace today. Lord, we need you today to provide for us. We need your grace within our life, Lord, to provide that strength because when we are weak, you are strong. Lord, that when we face temptations and the temptations that come our way, well, Lord, we pray that you would give us the grace to overcome them today. Provide us with the strength, provide us and give us that guidance, Holy Spirit, to overcome in every area. We thank you, Lord, and we ask you to come into our lives. Lord, we thank you for this grace, Lord, that is available to us. Lord, we know that in you all things are perfect in every way. Lord, give us the strength to be honest with each person. Let us be an instrument of grace today. Let us be more like you, providing them unconditional love to each person that comes our way. And we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Give us a path and let each person that sees us today know that you are the God. You are the God that we serve and you provide for us. You protect us. Your grace abounds in us. Lord, I pray for each person. Let your grace be their portion today. Just touch each person. Lord, touch them deep down into their souls today. Lord, that I pray that, Lord, that Lord, everything you do will be sufficient in their lives, and you will provide and make a way where there seems no way. I pray also for their loved lost ones, Lord, that you would deliver them, set them free, and prepare them for your imminent coming. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and believe. Amen and amen. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming and the snatching away of the bride of Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And if you've liked this particular utterance today, I encourage you, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, you can follow us on Facebook, you can also follow us on Instagram, go to our free website, repentancerevival.com. Precious saints, we have the 4-day fasting program that is later on in this month. Starts on the 28th, goes all the way to the 31st. Precious saints, there is 52 pages within this program. So you don't have to wait to then to read it. You can even read it now. You can read the whole thing now and then go in depth to it during the fast. I would actually encourage you to do that because there is so much there which is preparing us for the end times, precious saints. We are here. This is also going to be like a guide for those that are left behind. Maybe it's your dear loved ones that you know that are not saved. We're still believing that they will be saved. Some will have to go through the tribulation for them to realize because they've hardened their hearts. But let me tell you, God's grace is sufficient for you today, precious saints. I just encourage you today to seek the Lord where he may be found. He is always waiting for us to spend time in his presence. So from my family to yours, God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you, precious saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.